Peppermint is a new action film from the director of Taken and starring Jennifer Garner. Since I'm a fan of this genre as well as Garner, I was actually pretty excited to see this film, so let's talk about it. In the film, 5 years after Garner's husband and daughter were killed by a drug lord, she returns to exact vengeance on the people responsible for their death and the miscarriage of justice. Hi, if you're new here, my name is Sean Chandler, and I started this channel because I was driving people around me crazy talking about movies way too much. If you can relate to that, you're probably in the right place, and I'd love it if you'd join me down in the comment section and tell me, what did you think about Peppermint? Did you love it? Did you hate it? Are you not interested in it at all because of the basic premise of the movie? I'd love to hear your take on the film. With that said, let's get started talking about the good. And probably the absolute best thing about this movie is that it is an unashamed action movie. It is not embarrassed at all that it is a revenge film that is all about watching some bad guys get what is coming to them. For a while, it seemed like this genre had kind of taken a back seat, and over the last couple years, it seems like we're getting a more steady stream of action movies like this. And I love this genre. This is stuff that I can just eat it up, watch it all day long. And so very excited to get to see another movie like this that is not embarrassed at all to have Jennifer Garner shoot a whole bunch of people right in the face and have blood spray everywhere. Speaking of Jennifer Garner, she's another highlight of this film. I don't really think there's a lot of actresses that can pull off specifically what this role requires, and that's that they have to be convincing as the person throwing punches, kicks, and shooting people in the face, as well as being a sweet, kind, maternal mother. And that's kind of specifically what Jennifer Garner is kind of wired to do. And as an action revenge movie, it's very important that the film sets up some characters that you hate, that you want them to pay for what they've done. And this movie does that very well in the first third of the film. From there, let's move on to the mixed aspects of this film. And probably the big thing that comes to mind is that this movie is essentially what you think it is. I saw a lot of people on the internet before its release saying, isn't this just like Soccer Mom Punisher? Yes, this movie is essentially Soccer Mom Punisher. Some of you hear that and you go, I'm not interested at all. And other people are gonna go, that sounds awesome. I'm more in the that sounds awesome category, especially because of the director and Jennifer Garner being involved with it. It has no pretenses of transcending the genre, reinventing the action movie. It's just delivering what genre fans want. Some people roll their eyes at it and some people will have a good time at the movies. From there, let's move on to the bad. Superficially speaking, since this is kind of a throwback action movie, you have to suspend an awful lot of disbelief to buy into the world that they're creating of how corrupt the police and the court systems are and how incompetent the news are. There's a lot of different moments you're like, wait, the news are getting their information from social media? The news couldn't put this together? But on a much deeper level, this is an incredibly frustrating movie to watch because as you're watching the film, scene by scene, you can imagine a better version of the movie. You can imagine a better version of each of these scenes. Not by radically changing the story, they just omit such obvious things. To give you an example, in the setup of this movie, it is designed to make us hate certain characters, therefore justifying Jennifer Garner's character exacting horrible revenge on them. And what I'm about to say is gonna move broadly into spoiler territory, so if you wanna go in totally clean, just go ahead and skip forward about 30 seconds. But essentially, the movie has like seven people that we want to see her punish, and several of them happen off screen. We are informed via dialogue that she's done things. And as you're hearing, you're like, well, I wanted to see that. That is literally exactly what I paid for when I went to go see this movie, is to see that thing happen that you just told me in a line of dialogue, which seems like a major misunderstanding of the genre and the appeal of your film in general. So while I found the movie to be very watchable, it's also a movie that the entire second half of the film, I was thinking of a better movie that I should have been watching. Before I give you my final score, go ahead and tell me down below, what did you think of Peppermint, or did you just skip it entirely because Punisher Soccer Mom didn't appeal to you at all? As for me, I gotta give this one a C+ and just a 6 out of 10 on the entertainment scale. If you enjoyed this review, go ahead and check out this playlist to the left of my ranking of some of my favorite movie action franchises, or if you want more videos like this, click that subscribe button right down below. Thank you so much for watching, and keep talking movies too much.